Welcome to my very first Big Brother's Big Mouth. Last week, I was thrown into the deep end as fake housemate Pauline. But tonight, I'm out and here at Big Mouth, ably assisted by former celeb Big Brother housemate Vanessa Feltz. And this morning's fashion expert, John Scott. And of course, where would I be without this lovely audience? You're beautiful. Well, we'll be chatting to them a lot later, but first, Ziggy's constant crusade to be taken seriously took a setback today.
If I can tell you something, yeah?
There's been plenty of talk about the size of Brian's equipment, but it seems that he may have had some seriously stiff competition from Ziggy. No wonder Chanel's always crying. And finally, Big Brother's plans to introduce a new housemate have been poo-pooed by Carol.
Because I personally don't feel that we should now swap Chanel for a clown.
Sorry, Coco, you're out on your bike. You don't even have a bike. You're rubbish. That's my suitcase. Does it still smell of poo? Now, I want to hear what you at home have to say about the current events in the house. So please phone us, text us your email, email us, or send your eyepieces and messages via the website. Now, on a more serious note, first, he lost his girlfriend. Now, it seems he's lost his closest confidant, Carol. What has become of Ziggy? We've called this discussion Zig a Zig. Vanessa, I didn't get to know Ziggy very well in the house because I think he kept his distance from me with the whole Chanel thing. Do we feel sorry for him?
If you want me to diss the Zig, you're looking in the wrong place. I am a fully paid-up member of the Ziggy fan club. I'm sorry. I love the guy. He is a decent fellow. I don't know what he's doing, wasting his time with that Chanel. She is not good enough for him. She hasn't got the intellect he deserves. She hasn't got the charm, the wit, the savoir-faire that he deserves. He needs an older woman, well-studied, with possibly a peroxide blonde. Weight problem, a yo-yo dancer, maybe a failed talk show host. That's the kind of woman he needs. Someone who could really understand him and give him a bit of sucker. Because that's what he needs. A bit of sucker.
I think maybe. So what about John? Let's go to you.
I can't bear him. I think he's weak. Well, he's weak, he's behaving much. He's 19, how old's he? 30-something. He's behaving like a child, isn't he? He can't argue properly, just turns over or rolls over in the bed. When he's fighting with Carol, he walks away.
He's trying to be a gentleman.
No, rubbish, he's weak.
What does everyone here think of Ziggy? What do you think of Ziggy?
I admit, Vanessa, you've got a point. He's good to look at, but that's about it. We like to look at
him. Does he try to look too good in front of the camera?
He's navigating a very difficult course.
He's gone. He has gone from hero to zero. He's even lost his sugar mama, Carol. He's fallen out of everybody. He is a Billy No-Mate.
Do we not think he's a bit worried about playing the good guy? Do we not? Is he too concerned about or playing the bad guy?
He's been portrayed totally wrong. I think he came into the house, he was a really lovely guy, he was really genuine, really friendly, just wanted to be a good bloke. And Chanel's badgering him the whole time, jumping
down. You disagree?
I think he's playing the game the most. He's the most biggest game player in the whole thing, and he wants to win. You can see it.
Is it Chanel's fault? You want to talk. Is it Chanel's fault?
No! I'm talking about Ziggy again. He came in, he was a nice guy, he showed flashes of cheese, then he just became the cheesiest bloke in the world. I could walk through a dairy section in a supermarket. My man's. There's cheese coming from all over the place. There's cheese. He's the man where all the cheese is at. That's what I'm saying.
Can you relate to him? Because you seem pretty confident.
I'd
relate to him if he'd been on it a bit more in the house, but.
Can anyone else relate to him?
No. Can I ask a question quickly?
Vanessa!
Time Carol got hers and he finally stuck it to her. She's bossing everyone around. She's like someone's old grandma on speed. They didn't go in there to be told what to do.
It's time. We've got an email now. I've got to read out this email. Okay, it's from Dave in Birmingham, and he says, I am sick to the back teeth of all the Ziggy bashing. Give the guy a break. Yes. He's suffered mental torture from his first week. Yes. He's a decent guy and he's got values. Ziggy to win. Mixed opinions. Does he have a game plan? Does Ziggy have a game plan? Yes.
Only person in the house who is so aware of the cameras. He plays totally to the cameras. He does. It's Ziggy and Charlie, but Charlie's blatant with it. Ziggy's like a bit sly with it, but he's totally aware of the cameras.
Ziggy mentioned in his audition tape that he wanted to be the first guy to get it on with two girls, play him off each other.
Well, it's not going to work.
Do we think that's going to happen with Charlie?
That's exactly what he's trying to do now. That's exactly what he's doing now. He's found out that you can't get away with it with Chanel. So now he's like playing up to Charlie, trying to get Chanel jealous, and he's doing exactly what he said he was going to do.
Let's see what his sister thinks, because we've got her on the phone right now. Ziggy's sister Zoe.
Good evening.
Hello, Zoe.
Hi.
Now, do you think, Zoe, that Ziggy would have got it together with Chanel in the outside world?
He definitely would have spotted her in the nightclub, no doubt about it. She's gorgeous. He probably, if he got into the situation he is in now, which is he doesn't know whether he's coming or going because he never says the right thing by her, it probably wouldn't have lasted, you know, much further than the point it has now, really.
What about Ziggy and Charlie? Do you think Ziggy would have got on with Charlie?
Charlie's not the sort of lady that my Ziggy would go for. Great, good fun on a night out, but he'd never have a
relationship. What about Pauline? Would he have gone for Pauline? Would he have gone for a bit of poo? Poo on his face?
I reckon he would have, actually. He loves a good sporty girl.
Looks, yeah, well, Pauline was quite sporty. Has he got a game plan in there, Zoe?
Ziggy's being himself, I'm afraid, everybody. Ziggy's a great bloke. He's got a lot to do with
it. Well, you heard
it from... and a good person, too. He's just being himself. I don't know if his game plan's working, to be honest.
Thank you.
He never seems to be saying the right thing by the women at the moment.
Thank you very much, Zoe.
My pleasure.
Good night. Thanks, Zoe. John. Has Zoe changed her views about Ziggy?
No, not at all. If that's him being natural, then I wouldn't want to know him at all, basically.
What about Chanel? Would we like to see Chanel flirting with other guys?
Well, I want Chanel to flirt with other guys to make Ziggy really jealous because he deserves it. He's, you know, he thinks he's the best.
Would it work?
No. Stop crying for once, please. Just stop crying.
Vanessa, what do you think about Chanel?
Didn't you think there was a moment there with Liam when she was being his magician's assistant? And I know all about this, having lived with Paul Daniels for a week, believe me. Didn't you think there was a second there where she was looking at the thickness of his rope there? She saw that, and she says something like, oh, your rope, it's got two bits on it or something. And I thought, oh, there could be potentially a little bit of chemistry between Chanel and Liam there. Did you not think? A little, yes, a tiny bit, just micro...
I absolutely agree, and I think there is some kind of sexual tension going on there, because I believe they're both sort of around about the same age. I think they're both young in mind, maybe young in body. So yeah, get it on. Yeah.
I thought maybe Carol was after him for a while. She loved him, trying to get Chanel out of the picture. But now they've had a little bit of a tiff, haven't they? Carol.
Hi.
Can I just say as well, if I wasn't gay, I'd tell you. But also, tonight with Ziggy, did you see them out of the lube? Them and the twins were rubbing on each other. I saw you were saying about them wanting a threesome together. Yeah. Maybe that could be it. Ziggy and the twins.
Maybe that's going to happen.